At this point in the class, it seems kind of arbitrary. What we do is we digress completely into Pi performance equation syntax. Why do we do this? Well, it's because we've got some things that require that you know about this performance equation syntax. We're going to do some calculations within Datalink. We're also later on going to do some calculations inside ProcessBook. And Pi performance equations is our expression syntax. So we need to learn about that syntax here first before we can move on. There are three things that we need to know first about Pi performance equations, three kind of fundamentals about the syntax. And you'll find all these things documented in this Pi performance equations reference manual. You'll find this reference manual available from within the program files PyPC directory. It's under the help subdirectory, and it's called pereference.chm. So three of the rules of thumb about working within performance equations is when you're using this expression syntax to write some kind of a calculation, and that's what we're talking about here. We're talking about writing expressions that result in some type of calculation, whether they're in ProcessBook or in Datalink. So just to give you a quick preview here, this is an example of a performance equation expression. It's very simple. It's the tag name sinusoid times 2. So it's basically the value of sinusoid times 2. Here's an example of sinusoid times 3. And you're going to see other examples as we go through. So the whole point of this is to write some kind of expression that implements a calculation in the places where calculations are required. Like, for example, when you're trending things in ProcessBook and you want a quick ad hoc calculation. Now the rules of thumb here, the first three kind of rules to live by here with performance equations is that numbers are always going to be expressed as just as simple numbers, and you'll also find arithmetic operators obey all the same rules of arithmetic operators, the rules of precedence, etc., and they're expressed the same way as you might see in any other expression syntax, like in Excel or in Visual Basic. Now the second rule is that tag names are always going to appear within single quotes. So if you have an expression this simple, 3 plus sinusoid, the word sinusoid, which is a tag name, appears inside single quotes. Here's another example, sinusoid concatenated with BA level 1. You notice both of them inside single quotes. Now we use the same delimiter here, the single quotes, for our timestamps. So anytime a Pi timestamp is used, either absolute or relative, we'll see that appear within single quotes. Now, incidentally, that last rule about tag names inside single quotes, you'll notice that in some cases, things like our tag search will put those things inside single quotes automatically. So, for example, here is our expression sinusoid times 2. If I were to say this is sinusoid times 2 plus the value of CDT158, I'd go out and do a search for that. You'll notice when I do that, the single quotes are placed for you automatically. But that's not something you can rely on all the time. Sometimes you'll have to be entering these expressions by hand. Now the third rule is that strings are going to be inside double quotes. Strings would include those things that are references to digital states. Like for example, if you've got a valve that's open or close, or a tag that's either active or inactive, on or off, those would be considered strings. So anytime you're using an expression like that, you'd put that inside double quotes.